Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about Power BI December 2022 release as part of Catch Up with Nags series. And this is going to be a last video for this year. And I'm going to come up with a lot of new topics in 2023 new year. And I will have a quick intro about what's the plan for 2023. That will be my first video for 2023. With this note, let's try to check it out. What's there in December 2022 for Power BI? Before going to the topic, we have this channel, a lot of free contents, which covers variety of topics, SSIS, SSAS, Power BI, SQL, so whatnot. So please try to utilize this free content, share with your friends and colleagues. Let's begin. So 2022 last update for Power BI, and what it is. So there is one advancement in the reporting, like slicer type formatting moved to format pane, because earlier there was some confusion over here, either here or there, where we need to format it. So every formatting option moved over here in the formatting pane. So right now you can't find this option anymore, because this is what you need to keep on following these updates, because earlier you might have seen these options. You are familiar with changing this option. Once the update has happened, you may be thinking like this feature is gone, you know. So keep updating yourself once you are familiar with Power BI. Just quickly go through every month update. So this slicer is no more anymore in the slicer pane. It will be in the formatting pane. This is the one. It's a very quick thing. And in the modeling part, they have introduced a three new DAX function, index, offset, window. So these functions are, those who are familiar from SQL background, they are very much familiar. A lot of difficulties we faced in DAX writing it when we want to move one position up or down or towards left and right when you order by certain items. So this index offset windowing function will help to get rid of those complexities in DAX. So especially this will be helper function called order by and partition by. These functions also come with two helper functions. So there is a blog post here which explains what is this index, when you can use it, all other stuffs. So you can quickly go through it. This will be very useful functions. And moving on to connectivity, there are a lot of connectors. Those who are working on this, they can go through it. I'm not so familiar with these connectors. Mostly I work on SSAS and SQL Server. Now let's move on to deprecation of getting started in the expanded view in the Power BI services. So mostly once you launch very first time, and there will be option called getting started, how you can navigate, how you can go through it. So they are going to depreciate all other stuffs here. And there is a considerable change in get data function in the Power BI service. In Power BI service, earlier there will be two options. Now they're going to have segregated into two categories: discover a content, whether you want to create a new content from the files, you want to create a new content, or you from your published contents you want to create reports, something like that, you know. So there is two categories over here. So that's what: build on existing data set, more ways to create your own content. So whether you want to create on your own or you want to create reports from the published data sets. So this is the option. And in November release, there was option called SharePoint and OneDrive, where you can upload those Power BI files, then it will be automatically sync when it is from SharePoint or OneDrive. From this point onwards, if you are storing your file, Power BI file, in the OneDrive, then it is no more supported. It has to be in the business. So OneDrive for business. So please, this is a warning message for those who are using the OneDrive for personal, right? Then track your metrics on the Windows app. So I didn't talk about metrics yet. I hope in New Year I will definitely cover the topics in Power BI services. Then there are lots of visuals introduced at the end of this year. You can see the following new visuals. There are around 20 visuals they have introduced as part of the custom visuals. You know, you can download from the app store. So that's it. I hope this is the end of the 2022 Power BI. I hope you enjoy the contents whatever I create, and I will continue to do my best all through the coming years. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Do remember that data is your asset.